sign deal. When this country was founded, only white male property owners over age 21 could vote. But people fought to change that, and we became a more inclusive democracy. After the Civil War, we amended the Constitution to allow non-white men to vote. We became a more inclusive democracy. In 1920, after years of struggle and against enormous opposition, we finally ratified the 19th Amendment, guaranteeing women the right to vote. We became a more inclusive democracy. In 1965, under the leadership of Martin Luther King Jr. and other great heroes, the civil rights movement finally succeeded in outlawing racism at the ballot box, and LBJ signed the Voting Rights Act. We became a more inclusive democracy. 1 year after that, the Supreme Court ruled that the poll tax was unconstitutional, that people could not be denied the right to vote because they were low income. We became a more inclusive democracy. In 1971, young people throughout the country were saying, we're being drafted to go to Vietnam and get killed. But we're 18 and we don't have the right to vote. We passed a constitutional amendment. The voting age was lowered to 18. We became a more inclusive democracy. The democratic foundations of our country and this movement toward a more inclusive democracy are now facing the most severe attacks, both economically and politically, that we have seen in the modern history of the United States. We are well on our way to seeing our great country move toward an oligarchic form of government where virtually all economic and political power rests with a handful of very wealthy families.
Yeah. to sustain private capitalist enterprises. Left to themselves, they can't sell their goods, they lay people off. It's a mass suffering. The fascist solution